VolitionRX, the life sciences company, is making good progress in developing its NYSEMKT blood-based diagnostic tests for different types of cancer. Chief Executive Officer Cameron Reynolds is on the line. Hello, Cameron. Thank you for joining us.
Hi. Good afternoon, Charlotte.
Now, Cameron, you have received European ISO certification for your NYSEMKT blood tests. Tell me, why is this such a significant breakthrough for the company?
Yeah, thank you, Charlotte. Basically, having a world standard quality system is very, very important in everything you do. And it's one of those things which doesn't necessarily make big headlines like our trial results and other work, our patents, which we've just announced, and the CE marks. But it certainly is extremely important and shows the great emphasis we have on systems and quality throughout our organization. And to have the groups we have certify us and the ISO certification and the process through the entire research organization has been many years in the making, but we're very, very proud and happy now that we're ISO certified and that our lab meets all those quality system requirements. So moving forward, as we develop more and more biomarkers for different types of cancer, it helps us to have a proper system in place so that we can really build on that.
The other announcement you've made recently is the fact that you are going to collaborate with Surrey University's Cancer Research Institute. Now, in a nutshell, it's about assessing the efficiency of your NYSEMKT blood test to detect early-stage prostate cancer. Is that right?
Yes, as well as other things. Our platform technology, the same biomarkers we've seen working in other cancers, we have about 27 now, and there will be several hundred possibilities, have worked in different cancers. So we're trying the same platform at a very low cost, extra trials, to see how they work in other cancers. But prostate is a little bit different. It's not just do you have the cancer or not, like in lung or colorectal, because prostate is a rare cancer where more often than not you'll leave the cancer in because it's more harm taking it out than actually the chances of it killing you, so or being very harmful. So what a very important question, apart from just cancer and healthy, is how aggressive is the cancer? Is it something the clinician will want to take out immediately if it's aggressive, or is it something which is more than likely just to be in your body for 20 or more years? So this trial is two-prong. Can we detect the original cancer better, and can we detect the aggressive cancers from the not aggressive cancers? As I said, prostate is quite unique. You would never leave a lung cancer in just to see if it's aggressive or not, because they're obviously very aggressive and deadly in the vast majority of cases. So it's a different question, and that's where we're hoping to answer both those questions with this trial, and also with the one we have with MD Anderson in the US, which is looking at different types of aggressive prostate cancers.
But can you tell me when we can expect the first results from your collaboration with Surrey University?
Yeah, we're working closely with Dr. Hardev Panda there, and the samples have already been collected, and the blood samples, and are very well documented. So I would expect to see the first results sometime next quarter. Our assays are already developed for the other cancers, and we are now, as you've seen from our press releases, we're now fully automated. So we can do this number of biomarkers in a relatively short number of months. So I would definitely expect to see something in Q2 of this year from this trial.
So is everything developing according to plan? I mean, how confident are you that you will reach your target of bringing to market NYSEMKT blood-based tests in Europe anyway this year?
Yeah, quite confident. We've have our first CE mark, which we announced last year. And we're in the process now. We have a full quality system of CE marking each one of our biomarkers and then as a panel. So I think there's a very good chance we'll have that panel CE marked this year and launch the first product in Europe this year. Though that's not to say it's not something where immediately we'll be selling millions of tests, because it takes time to build up market awareness, key opinion leaders, and the process. So we wouldn't expect to see meaningful large sales more till 2018-19. I mean, we do think our tests, if they continue along the way they are revolutionary and will change the way cancer is diagnosed. But I think it's reckless to have huge projections very, very early on for revenue, because it always takes time to generate awareness. And clinicians, quite naturally and quite understandably, are quite conservative. They like to know of a new product for a few years before they change from their current standard. But so we'd see launching this year and some serious revenue taking a good year or two to really hit into the balance sheet because of the reasons I said.
Okay. Well, Cameron, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Charlotte.